Oil is not a renewable resource, but it is an extraordinary source of wealth creation. So I think what we have is really a unique window of opportunity for Africa to convert its oil and mineral wealth into sustainable economic growth. By being absolutely transparent about the payments that we're making to governments, that really enables the citizens of the countries where we're operating to hold us to account, but also to hold their governments to account for the use of the oil revenues that they're generated. And also by publishing what we pay, we're really demonstrating the contribution that we're making to the economic transformation of Africa.
Our total payments to major stakeholder groups are in excess of $1.5 billion. Some $900 million, or 60%, payments to governments. The lion's share of Tullow's business is in Africa, and consequently some 87% of our payments to governments are in Africa.
Some of those governments do rank fairly high on the Transparency International Index of Corruption. So it really is, I think, a particular responsibility for us, because of our success as an explorer in Africa, that we really do increase transparency.
Payments to other stakeholder groups include, first of all, payments to our employees in the countries in which they operate, some $250 million, paying dividends, some $175 million, and finally, discretionary social projects, $20 million. Typically, the revenues net of the appropriate costs, the local host countries receive somewhere between 60 and 80% of those net revenues. For countries without an oil industry so far, absolutely it's a game changer.
If you take a country like Uganda as an example, the in-situ value of the oil reserves in Uganda at the moment are probably somewhere in the order of $100 billion. Now the government's share of that is about 70% of net revenues after costs. So at today's prices that could amount to say $40 to $50 billion. Now just to put that number in context, the GDP of Uganda is about $17 billion. The international aid budget to Uganda in 2011 was about $2 billion. So you can instantly see that oil has the potential to absolutely transform the economy of Uganda. The biggest single contribution that we make to the creation of shared prosperity in the countries where we operate is actually the taxes that we pay. So being transparent about those taxes, I think, is absolutely critical first step. It's not going to solve all the problems, but it's a critical first step to converting oil wealth into sustainable economic development.